I am so freaking sick and tired and just fed up to hear with the left perpetually passing off this lie that Donald Trump endorsed white supremacists and Ku Klux Klan members, neo-Nazis, and racists when he made comments about Charlottesville in 2017. It never happened, and I'll prove it right after this. Before we go any further, please subscribe to my channel and click on that little bell so you get notified every time we've posted a new video, which we do pretty regularly.
When he said that Nazis and skinheads in Charlottesville, that there were some good people among them.
Let's set the record straight today, shall we? Donald Trump never said that there were very fine people in the Nazi Party, the KKK, or any other group of white supremacists or racists anywhere at any time. Not in Charlottesville or any place else. No matter how much you liberals want to believe he did, he didn't.
That's exactly what he said. There are people, good people on both sides.
No matter how much the lamestream media wants to believe it happened, it never happened.
The president continues to believe, against all the evidence, that there were very fine people on both sides at the alt-right, neo-Nazi, white supremacist Unite the Right rally that took place in Charlottesville, Virginia, two summers ago.
No matter how much a diabolical political hack politician says it happened.
He, on the issue of Charlottesville, and Donald Trump, when asked about it, said there were fine people on both sides.
It never happened. And as far as these lying hack politicians are concerned, I would remind you that Kamala Harris, who you just saw right there, has admitted on national television that at least when it comes to debates, you can't believe anything she says. She's admitted that she lies during debates.
How do you go from being such a passionate opponent on such bedrock principles for you, and now you guys seem to be pals?
It was a debate.
Not everybody landed punches like you did, though.
It was a debate.
So you don't mean it?
It was a debate. That the whole reason, literally, it was a debate.
It's okay to lie. It's a debate. You expect people to lie during debates. What's wrong with you, Stephen? Look, on August 15th, 2017, Donald Trump was holding a press conference at Trump Tower, and he wanted to talk about infrastructure. But the press didn't want to talk about infrastructure. They wanted to talk about a protest that had occurred the weekend before in Charlottesville, Virginia. Here's CNN political analyst and columnist at RealClearPolitics.com, Steve Cortes, to explain what happened at that protest.
A group of white supremacists held a white pride rally in Charlottesville, Virginia. The ostensible reason was to protest the removal of a statue of Confederate General Robert E. Lee. An Antifa group showed up to counter-protest. The mayor and the police were totally unprepared to deal with the violence that ensued. Tragically, a young woman, Heather Heyer, was run over and killed by a neo-Nazi.
And during that August 15th press conference, Donald Trump suggested that there was blame to be shared on both sides of the protest, and he went on to say this.
But you also had people that were very fine people on both sides.
Now, was Donald Trump actually saying that there were some good neo-Nazis out there, that there were some very fine people on the neo-Nazi side? No, just the opposite. What the press did not show you, what the press did not report, was the comment he made immediately following that statement.
And you had people, and I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally. But you had many people in that group other than neo-Nazis and white nationalists, okay? And the press has treated them absolutely unfairly. Now, in the other group also, you had some fine people, but you also had troublemakers, and you see them come with the black outfits and with the helmets and with the baseball bats. You had a lot of bad people in the other group too.
Now what you saw there was something I call selective editing or selective reporting on just one aspect of a story, leaving out another aspect of that story, that same story that doesn't fit your narrative. So who were these other people that Donald Trump was talking about? Well, let's go back to Steve Cortes and he'll explain.
He was referring to another group of Charlottesville demonstrators who came out that weekend. Protesters who wanted the Robert E. Lee statue removed and protesters who wanted to keep the statue and restore the park's original name. This is what President Trump said about those peaceful protesters. You also had some very fine people on both sides. You had people in that group that were there to protest the taking down of, to them, a very, very important statue and the renaming of a park from Robert E. Lee to another name.
You had people in that group that were there to protest the taking down of, to them, a very, very important statue and the renaming of a park from Robert E. Lee to another name.
Now, so just to make sure everybody understands, let's play that clip where he condemns the Nazis, the white nationalists, the white supremacists, whatever. Okay, one more time.
And I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally. But you had many people in that group other than neo-Nazis and white nationalists.
It should be noted that the New York Times, no less, published a story confirming that there were good people at that protest. There were good people protesting the removal of the Robert E. Lee statue in Charlottesville. In fact, they published that little factoid the very next day.
Good people can go to Charlottesville, said Michelle Percy, a night shift worker at a Wichita, Kansas retirement home who drove all night with a conservative group that opposed the planned removal of a statue of the Confederate general, Robert E. Lee. After listening to Mr. Trump on Tuesday, she said it was as if he had channeled her and her friends who had no interest in standing with Nazis or white supremacists.
Now, there's another way that I can prove that Trump was not talking about Nazis when he said that there were good people on both sides. Do you actually think that Donald Trump believes that there are good people in Antifa? The leftist punks who were counter-protesting the neo-Nazi punks? Because if there were only those two groups protesting and the president thought that there were good people on both sides, he would therefore have to believe that there were good Antifa people. And believe me, I don't think Donald Trump thinks there are any good Antifa people, because there's not. Even CNN and MSNBC should have been able to figure that one out. So everybody understands the good people that Donald Trump was talking about that are on both sides of the issue were the protesters who believed that the Robert E. Lee statue should stay and those protesters who believed that the Robert E. Lee statue should be removed, not the neo-Nazis and the Antifa scumbags. And remember, the scandal of Charlottesville is not what Donald Trump said about neo-Nazis. It's about what the media and the Democrat Party said, he said, about neo-Nazis. Basically, MSNBC, NBC, ABC, CNN, CBS, NPR, The Washington Post, The New York Times, The LA Times, all spread vicious lies. News reporting is supposed to be about reporting the facts, not promoting some sort of a political agenda. I'm not a news reporter. I don't work in journalism. I'm just a tap dancing monkey with a YouTube channel. But I know the truth, and now hopefully you know the truth. Well, thanks for watching. Be sure and like this video. Subscribe to my channel. Share to your social media. And leave nasty comments below. God bless America. And death to the New World Order.